swearing in of the new county board member for District One, Denise DeBoer McWhorter.
Judge.
Thank you. Step up, please. Glad to be back when I'm not asking you for something. Still replace Judge Paisley as a retired judge for administering oaths and weddings, for all the evil, bad, difficult stuff, be sure to call him late at night. Are you prepared to take the oath of office? If you raise your right hand. I, state your name.
I, Denise DeBoer McWhorter.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
That I will support the Constitution.
That I will support the Constitution.
Of the United States.
Of the United States.
And the Constitution.
And the Constitution.
Of the state of Illinois.
The state of Illinois.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of the office.
The duties of the office.
Of District One County Board Member.
Of District One County Board Member.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
Congratulations.
Molly Alaria.
Here.
Aaron Allen.
Here.
Timothy Carlson.
Here.
Craig Corzine.
Yes, ma'am.
Ben Curtin.
Here.
Charles Diekler.
Yes.
Becky Edwards.
Yes.
Donna Kibbitz.
Yes.
Mike McClure. Vicki McMahon.
Here.
Chad Michael.
Hello.
Paul Schmitz.
Here.
Philip Schneider.
Here.
Marilyn Boggins.
Here.
Matt Wells.
Here.
All right, I'd like to ask for a motion to approve the minutes from July 18, 2017 as printed with any corrections or amendments to them. Motion by Paul, second by Donna. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? President and writing petitions, resolutions, or ordinance proclamations will be addressed in the committee reports or elsewhere on the agenda. Reading of communications.
Okay, so I spoke briefly with Dan about this. We did get an updated prevailing wage report for Illinois, which takes effect September 1st. And until September 1st, the one from June for this year remains in effect. And I spoke to a gentleman at the Department of Labor, and more likely than not, those rates will remain in place until next August. But he said I shouldn't say that, and we couldn't count on it. So I was going to propose to the board that I will continue to check each month for updated prevailing wage rates, and if the rates change, I will announce that, and otherwise I'll just state, like we have for the last year and a half, that the whatever existing one remains in effect, if that's okay. Okay, so we currently have the September 2017 prevailing wage report. It has been posted outside the boardroom and is on file in the county clerk's office for your inspection. We have the July 2017 public defender's report, which has also been placed on file in the clerk's office. The treasurer's reports ending 7/31/2017. The local solid waste fees funds report for July, first balance on hand, $562,587.95. Total receipts of $48,640.33. Been a while since you've heard another that rate. Total disbursements, $18,564.78, leaving a
dated August 1st for the motor fuel tax allotment transactions for July 2017. Beginning unobligated balance $395,279.14. Net motor fuel tax allotments of $48,148.22. Credits processed of $4,711.46. Leaving a current unobligated balance of $448,438.82. The road district and township report, also the motor fuel tax allotment transactions for July 2017. Beginning unobligated balance $14,695.13. Net motor fuel tax allotments of $128,829.19. Credits processed of $15,356.14. Leaving a current unobligated balance of $158,880.46. I received from the State of Illinois Department of Natural Resources Offices of Mines and Minerals Explosives and Aggregate Division, that's a mouthful, a proof of county receipt of MLCR-1B. It is a on behalf of the Christian County Limestone Company doing business as the Painted Limestone Quarry Company regarding the Painted Limestone Quarry mine or pit located in Section 19, Township 11 North, Range 1 West of Christian County. And it's just the permit that they have. We just place those on file and it's available for your inspection. Every year, we receive an annual invitation on behalf of the board for any of you who would choose to be a day speaker at the African American Contractors Association's National Conference held in Chicago. Unfortunately, we received this year's invitation on July 19th, just after the board meeting, and the conference was held on July 22nd. So I'm sorry if any of you were planning to do that. Next, mark your calendars, and next year we'll get you in. But they do invite us to speak every year, and it's just, I think it goes out all over for us. From CEFS, dated August 4th, during the month of June, Nathan Nichols, Mobility Manager, attended the interagency meeting, the RTC meeting, and an open house event booth at Dillville CEFS. Nathan established three new contracts with Lillibad. He also distributed info and flyers to various locations. He enclosed our copies of the Christian County June PCOM report to share with your board members. And, you know, we always talk about that PCOM, but we just kind of go past it. But this one does actually cover from July of 16 through June of this year. So it is a whole year. So with your indulgence, I was just going to read you real quick. The DOAP revenues for the year were $194,970. The 5311 revenues were $99,063. The contract revenues were $1,543. And the fares were $8,158. The system expenses were $187,211, leaving net revenues of $116,523. And it does cover like how many rides there were, how many costs, what the cost per trip was, the number of days of service. It seems like March was our busiest month, but there were also 24 days of service in March. There were, but all of that's available in my office if any of you want to see more specific numbers on it, but it does seem like it's catching on and it's getting more use. Last one that I received, August 8th, 2017, from the City of Assumption, pursuant to the State of Illinois statutory requirements. They sent us a letter basically informing us that they're in the initiating planning studies for a TIF district in the City of Assumption. And that's all that I have this morning.
I'd like to ask for a motion to accept communications as read. Motion by Aaron, second by Matt. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Okay, are there any public comments? Okay, committee reports. I'd like to ask for a motion to set the minutes as printed. Motion by Becky, second by Chad. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. And we'll start off with the highway.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Thank you for coming.
Thanks for having us.
Wasn't mine, really. The meeting of the Highway Building Grounds Environmental Welfare Zoning Committee was called for Wednesday, August 9th at 6:30 p.m. at the Christian County Animal Control Building. Purpose of the meeting was county building issues, highway business, and any other matters properly brought before the committee. There were no public comments. Starting with building updates, the committee toured the animal control building prior to calling the meeting to order. Maintenance supervisor Zach Hicks reviewed current projects for many of the buildings, such as the health department has a floor installation project. The highway building, Zach mentioned that he's torn apart the 20-year-old boiler to check for any leaks. Hopefully it will last another 10 years. He thinks he can fix it. He also clarified that the courthouse air conditioning project, that $68,000 is for the complete conversion of the third floor. The units will be more localized by office, and two larger units will be used for the common areas. Solid waste office has had very few problems. The jail, he mentioned, is a constant battle with numerous issues. The animal control building has several projects that keep getting moved down the list as that building's in pretty good shape. The committee did suggest that the dog wash and pen cover projects be hired out with Zach's approval. Probation has had lighting switched out to allow individual offices lighting without turning on all the lights in the building. Moving on to solar siting. Zoning Officer Brett Rare reported to the committee that many calls and questions have been coming through his office about solar power requirements in this county. He explained that there are grants and funding available for solar energy projects by the state and the federal governments. A sample ordinance from another county was distributed to the members for review and suggestions brought to the committee possibly next month. Russ suggested that a standalone ordinance be developed soon in order to be ready for the potential application for solar sites. Currently, if requested, a solar site would have to be zoned industrial 2 with a special use for power generation. A bigger concern to be addressed in an ordinance would be provisions of decommissioned solar sites. Building permits fees are in place that would be applicable to solar sites. The Luke Bryant event. The issue of zoning was questioned about the upcoming Luke Bryant event in rural Edinburgh. Within the zoning ordinance, there is nothing that deters the event and nothing to obtain any special permit. As the director, Mike Cruz, has been working for months with law enforcement and responders for an emergency plan and security. The issue of liquor licensing was asked, and to date, no one has come to the county to inquire. Moving on to highway business. Highway Department Head Engineer Cliff Rye brought several purchase requests to the committee. Starting with the compactor, quotes were presented for the purchase of the Jumpin' Jack compactor with the following results. United Rentals, $2,671.98. Ron Equipment, $3,199.44. Patriot Equipment, $3,077. A motion was made and seconded to accept the low quote from United Rentals, and the motion carried. I put that in the form of a motion.
Okay, we need a second. Craig? All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried.
Next, we had some culvert quotations. They were presented for a culvert to be replaced in Bear Creek Township, northeast of Palmer, with the following results. Contech had a bid of $9,216, and Metal Culverts had a bid of $9,848. This is for an 84-inch diameter by 80-foot long polymer CMP. Motion was made and seconded to accept the low quote from Contech, and I put that in the form of a motion.
Second. Charlie? Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Next, we had a concrete box culvert. Reinforced concrete box culvert quotations were presented for a culvert to be extended in Greenwood Township with the following results. County materials, $6,725.50. Mechanic concrete products, $6,710. A motion was made and seconded to accept the low quote for Mechanic concrete, and I put that in form of a motion.
Molly? Any comments or discussion, any questions? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried.
Next, we have a resolution. Resolution R2017-HY013 appropriates an additional $2,149.10, which goes back to making it now a total of $25,631.30 from the County Bridge Fund to pay Christian County's share of the joint culvert project with Montgomery County, approved by Resolution R2016-HY015. A motion was made and seconded to recommend the full board adoption of Resolution R2017-HY013. I'll dispense with the reading, I'll put that in the form of a motion. And let's hear if anybody has any questions regarding.
Okay, give me a second. Great. Okay. I think this, I believe this should be roll call.
Molly O'Leary?
Yes.
Aaron Allen?
Yes.
Timothy Carlson?
Yes.
Craig Corzine?
Yes.
Ben Curtin?
Yes.
Charles Steeler?
Yep.
Denise DeBorme-Ward?
Yes.
Becky Edwards?
Yes.
Donna Hibbs?
Yes.
Vicki McMahon?
Yes.
Chad Michael?
Yep.
Paul Schmitz?
Yes.
Bill Schneider?
Yes.
Marilyn Boggitzer?
Yes.
Matt Wells?
Yes.
Motion carried.
A petition was received from property owner in the Bell, from a property owner in Bellhaven Edition subdivision that has property adjoining the street platted as Pile Drive. Pile Drive was platted but has never been laid out or opened for public use. County engineer and township highway commissioner approved the removal of the platted street from the original plat of Bellhaven Edition subdivision. Motion was made and seconded to accept the petition and recommend the full board to adopt ordinance 02017-HY010, which would remove the reference roadway from the original Bellhaven Edition subdivision plat. I will dispense with the reading and put that in the form of a motion.
Okay, give me a second. Aaron? Roll call.
Aaron Allen?
Yes.
Timothy Carlson?
Yes.
Craig Corzine?
Yes.
Ben Curtin?
Yes.
Charles Steeler?
Yep.
Denise DeBorme-Ward?
Yes.
Becky Edwards?
Yes.
Donna Hibbs?
Yes.
Vicki McMahon?
Yes.
Chad Michael?
Yes.
Paul Schmitz?
Yes.
Philip Schneider?
Yes.
Marilyn Boggitzer?
Yes.
Matt Wells?
Yes.
Motion carried.
That concludes highway business. Moving on to dog park requests. Jolinda Conrad, Animal Control Warden, proposed to the committee members the development of a dog park next to the animal control facility. It is her desire to move the impoundment lot to the north of the property and build the dog park next to the facility's parking lot. The fenced-in area would be divided into two sections, one area for small dogs and another for larger dogs, with an entry slash holding area. Fencing costs are quoted at $26,227 plus labor. Zach and staff would not be available to do this work. Within the fenced area, a pavilion and seating would be erected for the owners. This cost is estimated at $3,302 plus labor. Cleanup stations, running ramps, dog toys, a swipe card system, lights, and water would be other costs of the project. The money for this project has been approved by the Givens family for money that was given to the county for the animals. Several questions need to be addressed concerning the proposal, such as the labor for the building, the fence, etc. Attendance and or animal control staff involvement, liability, volunteers, continuing maintenance, and utility bills. Chairman Schneider noted that it is a good idea, but he doesn't want the county to be involved with the dog park. Maybe volunteers or an organization could take it on as a project. Another member commented that it was a fantastic idea, but maybe the county could lease the property to a group, but then the question of liability comes back. With several questions, a motion was made and seconded to table the topic until members could consult with the state's attorney.
It's just something that we're checking into, like to privatize it, get away from the county and all that stuff. Of course, we own the property, there, that they get to lease it, you know, back to the county and that. It's still in development, there's a lot of things to be looked into yet before you jump forward with something like that, so.
It's all right. Thank you. We have a landfill in the county. Chairman Carlson briefly reviewed the incident of a dog killing lambs, which injured one and ended in the death of another. This will be discussed at the finance meeting this month. A motion was made and seconded to join the meeting, and the meeting was adjourned. This concludes my report. Thank you. Any questions from anybody?
Thank you. Okay. Okay, out of finance. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. The Finance Committee met on Thursday, August 10th, 2017, at 6:30 p.m. in the County Board Meeting Room, second floor of Christian County Courthouse in Taylorville, Illinois. The purpose of the meeting was to address agenda items and any other matters properly brought before the committee. Attendance was taken, and Finance Chair Becky Edwards noted the quorum. There were no public comments. First item was the reimbursement for the domestic animals killed or injured by a dog. On June 5th, 2017, injury and death of two lambs were reported to the Sheriff's Office and Animal Control. According to terms of Statute 510 ILCS 5/19 and the Christian County Resolution R2014CB005, an affidavit claim was filed with the State's Attorney's Office for reimbursement for domestic animals killed or injured by dogs. Chairman Carlson proceeded to determine weight of the dead lamb and the market value at the time, as well as the vet service for the injured lamb. The committee reviewed the requirements and approved the payment to comply with the statute. A motion was made and seconded to approve the payment of $304.75 from the animal control budget. I'd like to put this in the form of a motion. Mike?
I would like to say that Charles Nagle is here. She's going to order the
motion. Do you have any comments you'd like to make?
No. Is there any questions for you?
Okay. Any questions? No? I'd like to put this in form of motion. I'd like to have a roll call on that.
Second.
Scenario.
Tim Carlson.
Yes.
Craig Corzine.
Yes.
Ben Curtin.
Yes.
Charles Diegler.
Yes.
Denise DeBoer McCord. Becky Edwards?
Yes.
Donna Gibbons?
Yes.
Vicki McMahon?
Yes.
Chad Michael?
Yes.
Paul Schmidt?
Yes.
Philip Snyder?
Yes.
Marilyn Bobbitzer?
Yes.
Matt Wells?
Yes.
Molly Galeria?
Yes.
I failed to ask you on the ordinance.
You left me out the time before.
I skipped you. What was your vote on that?
I was going to catch you.
Two yeses?
Yes.
I'll vote.
Yes, two yeses.
All right. I did you two for one. Sorry about that.
Sorry.
Aaron F.
Yes.
Motion. Truly Aaron.
Truly. The next item is the Health Department budget. Health Department Director Nancy Martin presented a revised budget to the committee, and she noted that the Health Board had not yet approved the budget. Health departments across the state are all in financial strains. She noted the hardest part about projecting a budget is that many of her grant applications have either not been received or the submitted applications have not yet been signed. The health department is self-sufficient for both state and federal grants and fees for services, and currently the grants are not being distributed, and what is coming in is 3 to 6 months delayed. She also noted that a replacement air conditioner will be necessary by next year. Do we have any comments or just informational? The next is the claims. A motion was made by Aaron Allen and second by Paul Schmitz to approve the claims as submitted for the month of August. The motion carried. I would like to put that in the form of a motion.
Second. Chair. Discussion.
All in favor?
No. Aye. No. Roll call. No.
Okay, roll call. Okay.
Craig Corzine.
Yes.
Ben Curtin.
Yes.
Charles Diegler.
Yes.
Denise, I should have asked you, do you want to be called as Denise DeBoer McCord? Or
I go by the board. It's simple. I go by the board here, so.
Do you want to call
me? I think McCord would be fine.
Okay. Denise McCord?
Yes.
Becky Edwards?
Yes.
Donna Hibbins?
Yes.
Vicki McMahon?
Yes.
Probation Department union contract has been open since November 30th of 2014. Although the language has been negotiated with other three units, the salary was left open. The union membership voted to ratify the contract as a formality. The county by motion shall do the same. The probation officers were given an equity adjustment, which brings our officers more in line with the other probation officers in the Fourth Judicial Circuit. The contract period is 12-1 of 2014 through 11-30 of 2018. The starting salaries for the new hires for probation officers from the date of ratification of this agreement through November 30th of 2018, all newly hired probation officers will be paid $17.50 per hour or $31,850 per annum during their entire probation period. After 6 months, a newly hired probation officer or officers hourly rate will be increased to $18 per hour or $32,760 per year. Equity adjustments were specific by service, beginning at $18.45 an hour at the highest, reducing by an annual 10 cents per hour to all current staff under a year of service at $18.15 starting on July 1st, 2017. Starting on 12-1 of 2017, an increase of about 2% will be applied to staff. Secretarial staff, we have two secretaries that were awarded the same increases as the highway, circuit clerk, and courthouse employees over the four-year period, of which was based upon average salaries at about 2% annually. It should be noted that probation officers are reimbursed about 75 to 80% by the state. A motion was made and seconded to accept the asking probation contract for national agreement. Motion carried. I would like to put this in the form of a motion.
Aaron, any comments?
She wants a roll call. Ben Curtin?
Yes.
Charles D. Clark?
Yes.
Denise McWard?
Yes.
Becky Edwards?
Yes.
Donna Hibbett?
Yes.
Vicki McMahon?
Yes.
Chad Michael?
Yes.
Paul Schmitz?
Yes.
Philip Schneider?
Yes.
Carolyn Bogatzer?
Yes.
Matt Wells?
Yes.
Molly Alarian?
Yes.
Aaron Allen?
Yes.
Timothy Carlson?
Yes.
Craig Forbes?
Yes.
The last item is the budgets. The only discussion relative to the budget was a question if the insurance was going to be reviewed. Currently, the county has a balanced group of carriers, one each for liability, workman's comp, and health, three carriers. The health insurance renewal was completed in July, work comp renews in January, and liability renews in December. The committee discussed the possibility of taking the work comp and liability out to bid. However, after reviewing the time for bids to be received, we would not have enough time prior to approving the fiscal year 2018 budget. We will table this until 2019. Any questions or comments? Motion was made by Becky Edwards and seconded by Vicki McMahon to adjourn. Motion carried.
Thank you. Okay, is there any unfinished or new business? Nominating report. I give a motion by Chad, second by Paul. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried.
I'm sorry, I should have mentioned in new business because I'm just thinking that by the time we meet again, it'll be past that point. For petitions for the March primary for 2018 for half the board that'll be up. The first day to circulate those will be September 5th. So the county's closed on September 4th, but we will have the petitions available in my office and packets ready to go on September 5th. If those of you know that you're going to do it, that there are fillable forms online which will allow you to fill in the headers, which always seem to cause everybody confusion because it's legalese, sorry, Mike, but the rest of us don't speak it. And if you give me a call in advance, we'll go ahead and get yours ready for you, like at least one, so that you can see how it should be filled out.
What's the other one?
The filing period for that would be November 27th through
those of you that maybe new to it or may not remember it, everyone that's here at 8 a.m. is treated the same for each competing office, first person in gets placement on the ballot. If there's multiple people competing for the same office, there will be a lottery held. But the thing that a lot of people don't realize is the first mail of the day is included in that. So it could be you'll be the only person here at the start of the day, but by the time the mail comes, you could be in a lottery. Another thing people often don't realize is you personally don't have to drop them off, because that sometimes is hard for me, for people to make the time. You can have anybody drop them off as long as everything's completed. My office does have notaries that will be available, but you can't come up until 8. But anybody that's here at that time, I'll treat everybody the same because there could be multiple sites that we can extend the rest. Trying to think if there's anything else. And remember, it is a primary first, so there will be two separate ballots. So if there's only one Republican and only one Democrat here at 8, including the mail, they're the first one on their individual ballots. Okay. And so some of you will be asking for voter lists and that. We did do a countywide mailing in July, and as I was explaining to Denise last time, it's always like the wave goes out and the wave comes back. We mailed out 23,000. We probably got back about between 2,000 and 3,000 already. We processed and mailed out almost 600 transfers within the county and another 375 of people that were seeking more information about them before we can transfer. And I have probably about 1,200 that I have to look at on a case-by-case basis. So there will be a lot of suspensions and a lot of cancellations, potentially people's names changing and hip-hopping or popping back and forth between districts. So I'm happy to PDF anybody a current voter list, but when you actually get ready to circulate those petitions, I would get as current as you can. We'll do everything in our power to have the voter files as current as we can by September 5th, but I'm far and away not the only county clerk that did the required countywide mailing, so every day I've got things coming from other counties as well. But just current is always best we can get. And if anyone has any questions about how people can get registered, how we can update their addresses, or anything that my office can provide you on that, please feel free to email me or call me, and we'll get you out the information that we can. Okay?
Okay, there's no appointments or reappointments. So, last item, adjourn the meeting.
Motion to adjourn.